as natural tendency, natural or swabhavik constitution of brain. But sometimes it seems that the devotees are mother, gopis or sakhas. Have so much preety, affection to the persons and to the materials, paraphernalia, who are very dear and dear to Krishna. अपने आराध्य की अपेक्षा भी आराध्य देव की जो प्रिय वस्तुएं हैं और प्रिय व्यक्ति हैं वो प्रिय है। यदि कोई कृष्ण को बुलाना भी दे, वो थोड़ी सी गाली भी दे दे और राधिका जी के चरणों में नतमस्तक रहे तो ये भक्ति की हानि है। कृष्ण की कभी कभी गोपियां उपेक्षा करती हैं, अरे तरे सब सोती हैं, चोट चुट्टा करती हैं, आप यहां से निकल जाइए कहती हैं। और श्रीमती राधिका की एकांतिक सेवा में नियुक्त रहती है, ये भी प्रेम का भी भक्त है। दूसरी बात, कृष्ण के खिलौने हैं, कृष्ण की जो प्रिय वस्तुएं हैं इनको भी कृष्ण से हरि यशोदा जी प्रेम प्रीति से सुरक्षित रखते। यदि नंद बाबा ने यशोदा बाजार से एक खिलौना कृष्ण के लिए दिया, ये कृष्ण नंद बाबा went to market and purchased some very beautiful toys for Krishna, and Krishna is playing. Oh, very he is happy. But anyhow, one leg of the toy was broken, and Yashoda man saw what she will do. Why you did so? This toy for Krishna. इसलिए यशोदा जी कृष्ण को श्रृंगार करती हैं। यशोदा जी से बहुत जोर से जल्दी से दूध मथा हुआ मथी हुई दही चारों तरफ में फैल गई है। और उसमें एक चीज देखा, कृष्ण के नन्हे नन्हे पैरों के दाग, जिसमें कि उनके जो लक्षण है पैरों के, वो सब उसमें लगे हुए, बजर खजा अंकुश इत्यादि, कहीं गाढ़ा है तो नहीं भी है, यहाँ जरा छिछला है, वहां पर उसके दाग देख करके हंसने लगे, मुस्कुराने लगे, बड़ा ठीक है। तो नौ पैर कम सो भी है वो नट ऐसे बड़ी शादी, अदरवाइज इज मोर नॉट इफ ही विल बी आउट ऑफ कंट्रोल आर इट आर नॉट नरक हो जाएगा, इसलिए इसको पनिशमेंट देना जरूरी है। कृष्ण ने क्या किया, देखा कि मैया चली गई तो क्या करना चाहिए, उठ करके खड़ा हो गया रोते रोते, और दधी खान को सोचा जैसे ऊपर से गिरा दे सब, तो पकड़ करके उठा तो वो इतना दही क्यों के पार तथा से चिंता करो जे की करी, तथा उनके शिला पुत्र एक लोढ़ा पड़ा हुआ था, एक नोड़ी पड़े थी, नोड़ी के लिए ऊपर ना ऊपर मोटा था के नीचे पतला था के, ऊपर यदि नेंगे दे तारे में दे तार मतलब दोई मंत्र सोकरी थे के जब ऐमन क्या का मरते भी जे ऐ कुछ जनों दोई ना था के, और जब तुमको बच्चा ऐ तो थी जो सुदामा जी देखने का हाथ थे देखो तो ऐ तो तुम छोटू बुद्धि बच्चा चले ऐमन बुद्धि जाते वही नीचे दिए मेरे से जाते सब एकदम पड़े। तखन कृष्ण मने मने खूब आनंदित हो से देखी से बेस धारे धर चांदी दे खूब आनंदित, किंतु जखनी मायर मने ये माय एखनी बोधा चिरबे तखन तो हमें एक दुरुस्त करबे एई जन्य भय देखी हुए कि करो जे ओखान थेके चले गेल खय एमन खरे गेल जे तार कोटि दारे जा একটা আঙ্গনের দিকে আর একটি ওই যেরকম ওই ঘর ওই ওর দিকে দাঁড়ে যা এই দিকে দাঁড়ে যা, ওই মধ্যে যে দেখলে যে একটা উদুখল আছে সেটা উল্টানো আছে, উল্টাইতে হবে উল্টানো আছে, ওই ওর উপর চড়ে দিয়ে আর মাখনে রূপ সম্বরণ না করে সেইখান থেকে মাখন নিচ্ছে, ইতিমধ্যে তার মন্দার মাংখু রামলীলাতে আমি এদেরকে কিছু করতে পারি, তারা আমার জন্য প্রাণ দিয়েছে উপরকমের সেবা করেছে আর আমি কিছু খেতে দিই, তারা নিজের দিকে ফল ফুল খেয়ে কোন রকম ভাবে আমার সেবা করে, এবার তাদেরকে ভালো ভালো মাখন দিব এই জন্য মাখন খাওয়াচ্ছি। আর কাল প্রসন্নের দল রামচন্দ্রের খুব প্রিয় ভক্ত আছেন কাল প্রসন্ন, ওদের মানুষ এই জন্য ওদেরকে উঠে
Now Shri Gurudev is continuing the description of the pastime of Krishna being bound by Madhya Shura. When Madhya Shura had put Krishna down, he became so angry When children are angry, then they manifest some unique behavior. They bite their lips. Also, tears come at that time. So Krishna was crying and biting his lips, thinking, oh, what should I do? So then, he, first of all, he thought he would upset the yogurt pot. Madhyashoda had been churning yogurt in a big pot, and she'd gone to take care of the milk. So while she was gone, he thought, I'll turn over the yogurt pot. So putting his hands on the pot, he started to try to turn it over. But he's a small baby and the pot was so heavy. So he could not move the pot even 1 inch. So he thought, I cannot do this. So then he thought, I'll have to try some other method of mischief. So he took one pestle for grinding, one grinding pestle, and then with that pestle, he smashed a hole in the bottom of the pot. Why? Because of the material, the clay at the top of the pot is very thick and difficult to break. But the clay at the bottom of the pot is somewhat thin. And if he makes a hole in the bottom, Krishna is so intelligent. He's thinking, if I make the hole at the bottom, then what will happen? So he took the pestle and smashed a hole in the bottom of the vessel. And then all the yogurt started to spray out in a stream from that vessel and spread in all four directions, all over the kitchen floor. When Krishna saw this, he became so overjoyed. It was very beautiful to see the yogurt going everywhere. But then at the next moment, he was thinking, if my mother sees me, then I will be in trouble. So it's time to go. So Krishna, he ran away. And he ran into a room of like this room here at the entrance. This room has one door going outside and one door coming into the house on either side. In the meantime, when Mother Yashoda pacified the milk, she came back to the scene of Krishna's crying and she saw that the yogurt was everywhere all over the floor. But when she looked, she also saw that Krishna had inadvertently stepped in the yogurt. So when he ran away, he left a trail of footprints. And in his footprints, she could see all the signs on Krishna's feet, like a gold flag and the balik horn and so many signs on his feet. So Krishna, he went inside the room, which led to the outside of the house, and there was a grinding mortar, which was turned upside down. So Krishna, he saw some butter hanging from the ceiling and he climbed onto the grinding mortar and was taking the butter. At that time, many monkeys came and many crows came and Krishna began to feed this butter to the crows and the monkeys. Why? Krishna was thinking, oh, these monkeys, in my previous incarnation, these monkeys, they served me so much in my pastimes as Lord Ramachandra. At that time, I had no opportunity to feed them or take care of them. So now I will feed them butter. And these crows have appeared in the dynasty of Kakabushandi, one great dear servant of Lord Ramachandra. So I will reward the members of his dynasty. And in this way, Krishna is happily feeding the monkeys and the crows.
So when Yashoda, Yashoda Maa Yashoda Shivle, Tatatani Haanthe Lala, Aito Dushu Kutri, Aito Dushu Chhele, Bhai Chantur Tho, Kintu, Shur Yato Expert Ho, Shuri Karma Javar Samay, Kichu No Kichu Aita Jinish Chhaadate, Jate Tumis Kono Lakono Rukha Mere Santhan Pate. এমনকি পায়ের ছাপও যদি ছেড়ে দেয় কুকুরগুলি শুনে দিয়ে করবে কি? আর যদি কোন রকম একটা কাপড়ও ছেড়ে দেয় একবারে সেটি ওইকে নিয়ে রিসার্চ করে দিয়ে আর চোরকে ধরবে। চোর চোরি করে চায় যে যতগুলি আমার ঘর ধরবার চিহ্ন আছে ও সবকে আমি মিটিয়ে দিই নষ্ট করে দিই যাতে আর না। অনেক সময়তে দেখা যায় তারা চোর লোক লিখে মেরিট থাকে মেরিট দিয়ে তারপরে রক্তের দাগ লাগে যায় কাপড়ে ওই কাপড়টাকে পুড়িয়ে উঠে কিন্তু যাবে তো বাইরে তো ছাপ আসবে সেটা ওইতে অনেক সময় ফুল তুলিতে ওই পুলিশরা ধরে সেই সূত্র যখন আমাকে মনে করে যে সে পুলিশের হেড ডিপার্টমেন্ট তিনি হচ্ছেন সিআইডি না ও তার উপরে বলা আর কৃষ্ণ হচ্ছেন চোর চুরি করে দিয়ে অপরাধ করা হেতু ভয়েতে পাঠিয়েছে ও দুঃখ লাঙ্গে উপরি ব্যবস্থিত মার্গায় কামম দদতম সচি স্থিত হরিয়ানন্দমম সৌজ বিষে বিশঙ্কিতে ক্ষণম নিরীক্ষ পশ্চাৎসূতম মার্গম কৃষ্ণ জানে যে আমি চুরি করেছি দধি ভাণ্ড ফেড় ভেঙে দিয়েছি আর দইটাকে একবারে নষ্ট করে দিচ্ছি আমি অপরাধ করেছি বুঝেছে এই জন্য সেখান থেকে পালিয়েছে যাতে মা আমাকে না ধরতে পারে আর আমাকে না শাসন করে পারে দেখো যারা চুরি করে না যারা মনুষ্যের পক্ষে খুব সহায় এরকম হয় গরু কুকু এরা সবগুলি মানুষের কাছে থাকে পালায় না আর ওই সাপোকা ইঁদুর এই যারা অনিষ্টকারী ওরা কি করবে দেখেই পালাবে সর্প বাঘ এইসব যারা মনুষ্যকে যে অহিতকারী ওরা মনুষ্য দেখেই পালাবে চাই মার চাই না করে ছাড়পোকা ছাড়পোকা কি করবে ও শুইলেই ঢুকিয়ে যেখানে হোক এসে সাথে রক্ত
বিনা সাহায্যে চুরি হয় না পুলিশের সঙ্গে যদি না মিল
তাহলে চুরি হয় না সামনে দে আর এক শব্দ ও পুলিশ তার মধ্যে জরুর কিছু পুলিশ নিয়ে থাকে ও রাম খ সেই ঘরে ভিতরে যে তিনি ঢুকেছেন আর ওই উদুক্ষণ উল্টানো আছে কেন যে বানর অথবা কার পিট না করে এই জন্য মা উঠিয়ে রেখে দিয়েছে কিন্তু হয়েছে কি যে সে উল্টানো আছে কোথায় ঠিক যেখানে দড়ি শিকার হয়ে আছে ব্যাস তার সুবিধা হয়েছে তার উপরে চড়ে আর তারপরে মাথা দিকে লাগে কিন্তু কিরকম ভাবে বিশাল কেটে ইচ্ছা না দেখছে মা আছে কিনা মা আসলে যে জান এই যে এদিকে তাকাচ্ছে আবার এদিকেও তাকাচ্ছে বানর দিকে তাকাচ্ছে আবার রাস্তার দিকে তাকাচ্ছে রাস্তাটা ঠিক আছে কিনা ওর দিকে দাঁড়াটা খুলে রেখেছে ওই জন্য বানর কাজ দিয়েছে আর এদিকেও খুলে রেখেছে যে মা আসলে সঙ্গে সঙ্গে পালা এই চোরের মতো এখন মা কি করেছে শুধু মা কথা ইচ্ছা নেই যশোদা মা কৃষ্ণকে গর্ভে ধারণ করে কোন সময় আমি এই আস্থাপন করতে ছিলাম আমার মায়ের কাছে আর মায়ের যে ছোট কি বলে হ্যাঁ কাকি মায়ের কাছে যে আমি অমুক জায়গাতে অমুক কপ নিয়ে এসেছি এই দৌড়াইতে আমি অত তেজ আর এইসব গুলি বলছি কি কোনো একটা কোনো কথা বলছি তো ওরা বলছে কি তোমার আমরা গর্ভে ধারণ করেছি তোমার থেকে বেশি বুদ্ধি রাখি যশোদা মাও তেমনি কৃষ্ণচন্দ্র হতে পারেন সর্বশক্তিমান হতে পারেন অঘটন ঘটন পটিয়েশী হতে পারেন ঠিক থাকুন কিন্তু যশোদা মা তাকে গর্ভে ধারণ করেছে এই জন্য যশোদা মা মনে করেন যে আমি তার থেকে বেশি বুদ্ধিমান আর আছেও যে কৃষ্ণ মতন লোককে সে কন্ট্রোল করে রাখে সে দেখলো চোর পালিয়েছে চোর এই ঘরে আছে ওই পায়ের দাগ দেখে তখন সে ঠিক কি করল হাতে একটা জস্তি একটা পেন ছোট আজকে কি হয়ে এই জন্য নিয়ে আজ তো 8 বছর সময় ধীরে ধীরে বিড়াল যেরকম চলে যদি শুকনো পাতার উপরে যদি বিড়াল চলে তাহলে একই শব্দ মানে ধীরে ধীরে চলবে এখন যত বিড়াল অন্য লোক যদি চলে তাহলে খটখট করে শব্দ হবে বিড়াল চলে হবে না তো এই বিড়ালের মতন মা ধীরে ধীরে চলছে আর এমন চলছে যে কৃষ্ণ এদিকে তাকায় যেন ওকে না দেখে আর ছট করে চলে গিয়ে আর কপাটে আড়ালে দে কপাট আর ওই দেওয়ালে মাঝখানে কৃষ্ণ দেখতে পায় তারপরে দেখা যে সে এখন গ্রস্ত আছে নিচে আর নিচে ইতিমধ্যে ধীরে করে দিয়ে বিনা শব্দে যে তার পিছনে যে এমনি ধরে ফেললো মাত্র দু আঙুল থেকে গেল এমনি ধরবে তখন ঠিক করে দেখে লক্ষ্য দিয়ে ওখান থেকে পালায়ন করে রামচন্দ্র বাঙালি আর শুন সকতে হ্যাঁ সমঝ সকতে হ্যাঁ সমঝা হমনে জো কাহা ইউ হ্যায় ইউ হ্যাঁ এন্ড ইউ ক্যান দেখো আলে তো উসকো কাহা দেখে वो बहुत दूर बैठता है निकट पर बैठा करो तुम भी अपना नोट कर ले
हरे कृष्ण Krishna is very much clever. He is showing his cleverness. He has broken that pitcher. He has run away from there. Where he has gone, we have already known. He has just
stood on a udukhal, on the mortar, and he is eating butter and he is also distributing it among monkeys and crows. Mother Yashoda, he says, oh, so much clever and so much notorious, mischievous. Who is he? He is my son. And he is showing more cleverness than me? It can't be possible. Gurudev is saying, Krishna may be clever to any extent. Krishna may be all potent. He is Supreme Personality of Godhead. But the fact is this, that Mother Yashoda has given him birth. So finally she is mother. She traced out the footprints he has left over and she now is entering into the room where Krishna is there. How she is entering? She is entering very, very slowly. Herein Gurudev is putting very important point. What is that? Krishna is hiding himself. Why is he hiding himself? Because he knows that he has committed a mistake. That he is committing theft. So he is hiding himself. This is a fact. Who hides himself? Whoever does some mistake or who feels guilty, Gurudev is saying, who does anisht? There are so many insects, there are so many animals. They are harmful to human society. But generally they will never come in front of any human person. They will just run away. The moment they will see a single man, they will run away. But when man is not there, they will come and they will do harms to him. So this is the tendency, that if someone is harmful to anyone, he will never come in front of him. And this is the relationship. There are many disciples, they don't come in front of Guru. What does it mean? This means they have some guilt in their heart. They are not exactly following the order of Gurudev. Or maybe sometimes they may be harmful. They are giving some harm to Gurudev. They have some ill feelings in their heart. And those who have got no any fear in their heart, those who have got no any guilt in their heart, they will very frankly come in front of their Gurudev. They serve their utmost best quality. And they will also have any doubts, they will ask their Gurudev. Very pariprasne. Pariprasne means in very humble manner. They will not have any fear in asking their questions and clearing their doubts. And Gurudev also is very much pleased while clearing their doubts. Because this is the relationship between Guru and disciple. But those who have got guilt in their heart, they will not come in front of their Gurudev. Gurudev was explaining, also mentioning his relationship with his own Gurudev. So many disciples used to be very much scared of him. But Gurudev says that he was never scared of his Guru at all. He was serving him to his utmost toilsome manner, and at the same time he will always ask so many questions to him without any hesitation. And Gurudev was very much pleased with him. He is giving here an example of lion's cubs. Lion is so much fearsome to others, and but his cubs are playing on his head and on his lap, no, without any fear. Similarly, that Guru may be how much strong and like lion, but if his disciples are his like son, and they can very easily come close to him. But if they don't, if such those disciples who don't have any guilt in their heart, so. Another thing is that thief may be however clever, but whenever he leaves the place, he leaves some or other clues so that police can catch him. How come it possible? So Gurudev is also explaining that someone one may leave his footprints, one may leave his clothes, or some blood is there, some blood spot may be there, and one way or other, finally police catches him, because it is the fact, thief always leaves some clue, some sign. Krishna has also left sign of his footprints. Now Mother Yashoda is entering in that room where Krishna is standing on a mortar and eating butter. The moment she enters, she saw him, she becomes very slow and putting her foot steps in a manner that it should not create any sound at all, just like a cat when it moves. Cat moves on the dry leaf, also there is no voice on those dry leaves. Why? This is the way cat moves. So Krishna could not notice that his mother has entered in the room. Mother has come very close to Krishna, and now he is about to catch him. She is having a bone stick in her hand also. But somehow or other, Krishna is also omniscient. He could realize that something is going to happen. And Mother Yashoda was about to catch him. Only 2 centimeters away from Krishna, her hand was... Krishna jumped and from the holder and...
How Krishna knew that mother is coming?
No,
when mother was entering in the house, monkeys began to... and crows began to fly. So at once he looked at him.
So he smelled that something is happening and he ran. Now he is running and what will happen, let's see. So the question is, Krishna is not omniscient. Krishna could notice it because of this fact. Anyway, if even he could notice because of this fact, it does not mean that he is not omniscient. He is.
Tamayata Jastim Prasamiksha Satsara Tato Avalutya Apasatara Vitavat Gopanya Dhaman Jamamapa Yoginam Chamam Pravestum Tapase Tanmana. Krishna कैसे हैं? समस्त ईश्वरों के ईश्वर, सबके आदि स्वयं अनादि सर्वशक्तिमान कृष्ण है। जो भी लोग कोटि कोटि वर्ष तपस्या करके मन को पवित्र करते हैं, शुद्ध करते हैं, निर्मल करते हैं, और शुद्ध निर्मल के द्वारा भी कृष्ण के चरणों को स्पर्श नहीं कर पाते हैं ध्यान में भी। एक तरफ में कृष्ण ऐसी और दूसरी तरफ में मैया यशोदा साधारण स्थूल अंग की होती हुई थी। उसके ध्यान में नहीं आने वाले, युगों के ध्यान में भी नहीं आने वाले जो चरण कमल है और उनको पकड़ने के लिए दौड़ रही है उन्हें। काल जवन जिसको नहीं पकड़ सका, जरासंध नहीं पकड़ सका, कोई भी नहीं पकड़ सका, ध्यान में भी नहीं पकड़ सके, और फूल काय होगी यशोदा मैया कृष्ण से भी अधिक थी प्रगति से दौड़ करके उसको पकड़े। क्या तात्पर्य? देखो भाई, भक्ति राज्य बहुत ही विषम है, समझना बड़ा भारी कठिन है। कृष्ण की आराधना करता है भक्त, भक्त लोग भगवान की आराधना करते हैं, और कृष्ण की भी बड़ी कृपा रहती है भक्तों पर जो ऐसा भजन करते हैं साधकों। ये जथा माम प्रपद्यन्ते ताम तथैव भजन्ते, जिसकी जैसी प्रीति है भगवान के प्रति, प्रीति के अनुकूल कृष्ण भी वैसे ही प्रीति अपने भक्तों पर रखते हैं, वैसे ही कृपा करते हैं जैसा वो मांगता है। क्या बोलने जा रहा था? बोला था वो तो कृष्ण अपनी मैया को प्रीति करते हैं और यशोदा मैया भी कृष्ण को पास कर जाने से लालन पालन करते हैं। कृष्ण के प्रीति का जो गाढ़त्व है या जो घनत्व है उससे कृष्ण के प्रति यशोदा मैया का वात्सल्य का अधिक वैशिष्ट्य है, नहीं तो पकड़ नहीं सकती। गोपियों की गति और भी, भजनकनाओं की, कृष्ण प्रियाओं की गति और भी अधिक है यशोदा मैया से भी। इसलिए यशोदा मैया उनके पीछे दौड़ रही है पकड़ने के लिए। यदि कृष्ण के बराबर या कृष्ण से कम दौड़े तो कोई प्रश्न ही नहीं है पकड़ने का। यदि मां यशोदा कृष्ण अपेक्षा अत्यंत कम हिम्मत की पीछे इतनी दौड़ा चाहे को दिन धरते पड़े अथवा बराबर यदि होता है ना कृष्ण जी के बेसिक की प्रगति से दौड़ाना चाहिए। इसलिए
सेवा करता है भालू पर दिया अगर गुरु महाराज के कच्चे शिष्य को पर दिया
ताकि वो संन्यास दिए किंतु जब हम प्रभुपाद जी को भी देख लेंगे अनंत वासुदेव इत्यादि प्रभुपाद जी रुचि चौक होते लगे आज तहत संगे ये जुड़े गए तक गुरु महाराज बोले हमारे भ्राता होते पारे আমার গুরু ভ্রাতা হতে পারে আমার প্রিয় হতে পারে কিন্তু এর সঙ্গে আমার কোন আমি তার মুখ দর্শন করব কঠোর যদিও অর্ণব মহারাজ তাকে শিক্ষা গুরু মনে করে দিয়ে বড় ভ্রাতা হলেন তার আর কি করতেন আমার পালকিতে গিয়ে যেতাম পালকিকে দাঁড় করে দিয়ে আর কি করে আর তাহাকে সাষ্টাঙ্গ প্রণাম করতেন আমাদেরকে আদর করতেন কিন্তু গুরু মহারাজ কি রকম আমি এরকম ভ্রাতা দর্শন করি এইগুলি আদর্শ কিসের উপরে বললাম এইরকম চাই অনকল্লেশ সংকল্প প্রাকৃত কুল্লাশ বিভাজন রক্ষস দিতে বিশ্বাস কৃষ্ণ জরুর রক্ষা করবেন এইটি পূর্ণ বিশ্বাস গোপিত্বে বর্ণন আমি ওই কৃষ্ণের শরণ গ্রহণ করলাম উনি আমার রক্ষা করেন মারে কৃষ্ণ রাখে কে আর রাখে কৃষ্ণ মারে এই যে বিশ্বাস থাকা চাই এইরকম বিশ্বাস না হলে কেউ গুরু সেবা করতে পারবে না ভক্তিতে প্রবেশ করতে হবে কৃষ্ণ যদি আমি বরণ করলাম যে কৃষ্ণ আমাকে রক্ষা করবে আর তারপরে সুনাক্ষী করে দিয়ে ওর কাছে যাচ্ছি ওর কাছে যাচ্ছি একদম বিপত্তি আসলো তখন আমাকে রক্ষা করো এই সাধারণ লোকের নিকটে তাহলে তার শরণাগতি কোথায় কৃষ্ণের প্রতি কৃষ্ণের প্রতি শরণাগতি হয়ে আবার অন্য লোকরা মুখ কাছে লাগে হাত কাছে লাগে নির্ভীক থাকবে আমার গুরু রক্ষ বৈষ্ণব রক্ষ ভগবান রক্ষ আমাকে কেউ এরকম বিশ্বাস থাকবে সংকল্প প্রতিকূল নির্বাচন রক্ষা সত্যি বিশ্বাস গোপিত্বে বর্ণন তথা আত্মলেখে আমার যা কিছু সর্বস্ব দেহ যে কিছু আমার মাতৃ গুণা পদে আমার আর কিছু আমার বুঝিতে আর কিছু নাই আমার কানে সে কিছু কি আমার নেই আর সব নিষ্কার মেন কুকুর আমি তার কুকুর উচ্ছিষ্ট জাগতে দিয়ে দিব ওই জাগতে গ্রহণ করে আমার জীবন নির্বাহ আমার প্রভু এই কেমন এই কুকুর আর যাচ্ছে আর এত দৈপতে তার মালিক ওই কুকুরের পেটের মধ্যে দিয়ে তাকে রেখেছে বড় বড় কুকুরকে দেখলাম তার উপরে ঝাঁপিয়ে পড়ছে কেন যদি একলা থাকে তাহলে কুকুর থাকে আপনি কাটে দিয়ে শেষ করে কিন্তু মালিক তো আছে না হাতে বন্দুক আছে কি একটু লাঠি রেখে ওই দেখে যখন যার উপরে ঝাঁপাচ্ছে জানি আমার মালিকটা কত বড় ওই রকম হতে যারা কৃষ্ণের শরণাগত কোনো বিঘ্ন বাধা করে গুরু মহারাজ বলতেন যে গৌরকিশোর দাস বাবাজী মহারাজ তার আপত্তি বিপত্তি সাহতি সব কিছু নিয়ে নিয়েছেন বলেছেন যে তুমি নির্ভীক ভাবে প্রচার প্রচার করো সত্যে সত্যের নির্ভীক প্রচার আর গুরু মহারাজ সেই জন্য ওই বলেতে বলিয়ান হয়ে তোমরা তো জানো যে সেদিন অসম্ভব মধ্যেও একেবারে সম্ভব করে তার মধ্যে প্রাণ দিয়ে লাফিয়ে পড়েছেন আর সব কাজে সে সফল হয়েছে আমিও যাচ্ছিলাম বাসাতে আমরা বহু লোক ভয় দেখাইল যাচ্ছেন ইস্কন বাড়ারা আপনাকে সুর করে মারিয়ে দিয়ে বহু লোক মেরেছে আর সত্যি সত্যি মেরেছে তা আমি বললাম যে সে রাখে কৃষ্ণ মারে আমি দেখবো আর মরতে যদি আমার মৃত্যু হয় তাহলে তো আমি যখনই তখনই মরে যাবো আমি বঙ্গালি আপনি বুঝতে পেরেছেন নাকি ওকে বলি সমাজ তো বলি
आपकी बंगाली हिंदी जैसी लगती है
हमारा बंगाली अंग्रेजी हिंदी सब एक समान हम अंग्रेजी बोल रहे थे
This pastime is giving very, very valuable message to us. Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. Who is He? We should know. He is omnipotent. He is omniscient. And He is the creator of everything. And no one has created Him. He is Anadi and Adi. Adi means He is creator of everything. So much difficult. Impossible. So many mystic yogis, they are performing such a high class of austerity, cleansing their heart to fullest extent, are still unable to meditate His lotus feet in their mind. So difficult. And what is happening here? The same Krishna, whose lotus feet are unable to be brought in the meditation by these yogis since so many ages together, but Mother Yashoda is running after Him. The whole personality, running after the whole personality, and Krishna, he is running, and Mother Yashoda is chasing Him. Now, what does it mean? We have to understand. Kali Yavan, he wanted to catch Krishna. Krishna is just walking, and he was running after Him. He could not catch. Jarasan, he could not catch hold of Krishna. So many yogis and so many devotees, they are trying to meditate Krishna, they are unable to do it. But what happened with Mother Yashoda? Mother Yashoda is running after Krishna and she could catch Him. How could it be happened? So very important point Gurudev is raising here. We have to understand love. The intricacy of the love, intricacy of the love. What is this? Yashoda Ma loves Krishna and Krishna loves Yashoda Ma. Both are loving each other. But we have to see who loves more. The density of Yashoda's love for Krishna is more than of Krishna's love for Mother. Why? That is only it is possible that Yashoda Ma can run faster than Krishna. Because her love for Krishna is more than Krishna's love for her. If Yashoda, Mother Yashoda is unable to run faster than Krishna, she cannot catch. Even if she runs with the same speed of Krishna, still she cannot catch. She can catch only if she runs faster than Krishna. This means her love is more than Krishna. Today Krishna is showing His cleverness. Oh, my mother is a lady. How can she run in front of man? And if he goes to the highway and starts running on highway, she will never come. Because she always keeps herself away from the males. And especially in front of them, she cannot run. So he has gone to the highway and started running there. This is Indian tradition. That women, they keep veil in front of male, they keep veil in front of male, and senior males especially. But what to speak of running in front of them, they keep veil. But today, Yashoda Ma knows, Mother Yashoda knows that all male has gone. Today was the occasion of Deepavali, so all for cow grazing, all the males have gone. So whole highway is free from male. So there is no question of any fear and keeping away. So she has taken a vow. She has determined herself that she will catch Krishna. Gurudev is explaining here that such a determination is very, very essential if we want to catch Krishna. Sankal means determination. So he has given, he is mentioning here, 6 limbs of Sharanagati. Sharanagati means to surrender. To surrender is essential if we want to enter in the realm of bhakti. It is threshold and we have to cross this threshold to enter into a realm of bhakti. What is the threshold? Sharanagati. It has 6 limbs. The first is that anukul, whatever is favorable, we have to accept it. And that should be the determination. And whatever is unfavorable, we have to give up. So we should be very much clear in this point, as well as practical also in this point. Determine that whatever is not favorable in bhakti, we will give up. There is a verse, there is a poem of Tulsidas. It says, look, son gave up his mother because she gave up Ram. Bharat, he gave up his mother, Kekai. Because Kekai did offense at the lotus feet of Ram. Brother gave up his brother. Vibhishan gave up his Raman, his brother, because Raman was against Ram. These are the very, very ardent examples in our spiritual history. Disciple gave up his guru, like Bali Maharaj, he gave up his guru. And similarly, we see that Gurudev is giving example of his own Gurudev. His brother was very much dear to him. And he was very intelligent also. And Param Gurudev brought in him Krishna consciousness and made him surrender to his Gurudev. But during last years, after the disappearance of Srila Prabhupada, Gurudev found that his brother was associating with wrong elements, those who are against of Srila Prabhupada. So Gurudev was so much happy, so much angry against his brother, that brother was very dear to him, but he took vow that he will never see his face. So this is the example he has shown in his life, that how one should give up anything which is not favorable. Then the other limbs of Sharanagati, other limbs of surrender, shows that we should always depend upon Krishna. And we should have full faith that Krishna always protects us. If we don't have this full faith, then there is no surrender. We say we are surrendering to Krishna, but any trouble comes, then we start running after here and there and to the different people. No, we should have full faith in Gurudev. Gurudev and Krishna will always protect us. This is the way we surrender. Still, this is not bhakti. What is bhakti? Bhakti is when we are able to surrender to this extent, then we enter into the realm of bhakti. And finally is Atmanivedan. There is, we should think ourselves that we are of Krishna. We have sold ourselves to Krishna. Dehe jo kuch mor. Whatever I have, and including my this body, oh Krishna, it belongs to you. It is yours. I am your dog. Just dog has got no any freedom and liberty of his own. He has got chain in hand of his owner, and he cannot move here and there according to his own wish. But at the same time, he is saved by any attacks from the outside. Who saved him? His owner saves him. Similarly, if we give up everything to Krishna, then Krishna's responsibility is there. Gurudev's responsibility is there. They will protect us, but we should at least have this firm faith that they will protect us. Only then it is possible. Gurudev is giving his own example that whenever he is preaching everywhere, outside India especially, he is facing many difficulties, especially ISKCON people. They are threatening, they are giving him threatening also. And sometimes such threatening is coming to him, that danger to his life. And they are very much cruel in this regard. It has seen in their history that sometimes they use shooting and all also. But Gurudev says that he has got no fear, and he is not at all fearful, because he knows that he is being protected by his Gurudev and by Krishna. His Gurudev once went to Srila Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj, and he instructed him that you should go and preach fearlessly, boldly, and you should preach the absolute truth, and I guarantee you, I will take all your difficulties and impediments and obstructions coming in your life. Similarly, Guru always takes one's difficulties and obstructions if one is bent upon to preach fearlessly.
Attention, please. This afternoon, there will be a book table. I think it may be there every day, but we will have lectures available, Shri Gurudev's research classes in abroad as well as in India, and also some very.
Yes, Gopinath Mandir.
অপরিণত, কারণ অনেকগুলি দর্শন আছে, অনেক নেগেটিভ। আর তা না হলে আর সমাজ থাকছে না, অসুবিধা হয়ে যাবে। হ্যাঁ, তো এখন একটি বিশেষ কথা, এই গোবিন্দ গোপীনাথ মদন মোহন আমাদের দৌড়ি আর তীর ঠাকুর, তো তীর মন্দিরে একটি বিশেষ প্রথা আছে, সেখানে বিশেষ কিছু প্রণামী দিতে হয়। কম সে কম সময় টাকা প্রণামী লাগিলে ভেতরে আসতে দেয় না, তো প্রত্যেকে কিছু কিছু প্রণাম দেওয়া দরকার। অন্যান্য বারে অনেকে প্রণাম দিতে এবারে প্রণামী আসে না।
So
father, the process of bhakti, how will it take our goal? And Gopinath ji, he is the presiding deity of Prayojan Tattva, our aim and object. Praying, Krishna praying. So these three deities, oh, there is some speciality in them. Krishna has many different moods. What is the mood of Madan Mohan? He is called Dhirabhati. His mood is, oh, sometimes he can be angry, proud, boasting, fickle. This is his nature. And Govindaji, his mood is Dhirodhara. This mood, very soft and gentle, very forgiving, very courageous, and accepting the service of his devotees. And Gopinathji, oh, his mood is called Dhiralit Nam. Dhiralit Nam has been described by Srila Rupa Goswami Pali, which one is the one? Vaidakya Yavatakuna Parihasa Visharada Distinto Dhiralalita Syat Praya Prayasi Vashaha. Dhiralit Nam has many qualities. He like Kamadev himself. More than Kamadev, he is expert in all Kamkrida, all the amorous affairs of amorous love. Vaidakya Navataruna, like a fresh youth. Parihasa Visharada, always laughing and joking and making so many, playing so many games. Nischintya, he has no anxieties. He is completely carefree. And Syat Praya Prayasi Vashaha, most of all, he is controlled by the love and affection of Srimati Radhika and the gopis. These are the qualities of Gopinathji. So, Janava Thakurani, she came here and had darshan of Gopinathji. In most temples in Vrindavan, we see that Krishna is there and Srimati Radharani is on his left side, on the left side of Krishna. But here we see Srimati Radharani is on the right side of Krishna and Ananga Manjari is on the left side of Krishna, taking the interposition of Srimati Radharani. So when Janava Thakurani came here, she is actually Ananga Manjari. And in honor of Ananga Manjari, Radharani herself has taken her and kept her on the left side of Gopinathji. So we are very fortunate to come to this place under the guidance of Guru and Vaishnavas. So I am praying to the Sisi Radha Gopinathji that they would bestow their mercy upon me so that in some future life I can also hear his flutes, sweet flute singing. Sriman Rasa Dasarambi Vamsi Bhata Tatas Kitara Karshan Vayu Sunar Gopi Gopinatha Sriyasunaha. Gopinath is playing upon his flute and attracting all the gopis, calling them to take part in his Rasa Lila. So today we have many places to go, so our talk has been very extended. I think that we can discuss all these things back at the lunch in the afternoon. Shri Shri Radha Gopinath Ju Ki Jai, Shri Madhu Pandit Ki Jai, Shri Janava Thakurani Ki Jai, Shri Ananda Manjari Ki Jai, Go Premanande.
Stai sempre vicino.
It's an old temple with the Gopura. You can see. These are just groups of people on the way.
Education.
महाराज जी का अनुगत में जहाँ पर उपस्थित हुए हैं, यह स्थान का नाम धीर समीर है। पास में श्री रास मंडल है, जहाँ पर कृष्ण बंसी भट्ट को नीचे अभी अभी हम लोगों ने श्रवण किया, श्रीमान रास रसारंभी बंसी भट्ट तटस्थित कर्षण बेणु सुनेर गोपी गोपीनाथ श्री अस्तुन। कैसे श्री कृष्ण बंसी भट्ट को नीचे खड़े होकर के बंसी से जगो कलो बाम दृशा मनोहर, कैसे वो बंसी से क्लिंग शब्दों को उच्चारण करते हैं, और वो क्लिंग शब्द हम जितने मंत्र उच्चारण करते हैं उसको पहले देखिएगा क्लिंग है, वो जो क्लिंग में वो ऐसे के शब्द है जिसको अंदर में क ल बड़ा ई चंद्र बिंदु और अर्ध चंद्र, इसमें पांच अक्षर है। उसमें श्री विश्वनाथ चक्रवर्ती ठाकुर यह क्लिंग शब्द का जो विस्तृत व्याख्या किया है, कहते ऐसे कोई अर्थ नहीं जो क्लिंग शब्द का अंदर में उसका अर्थ नीत नहीं है, ये क्लिंग शब्द ऐसे है। इसलिए कैसे गोपियों ने
जब जाने के लिए तैयार होते हैं, कहते प्रभु और एक दिन ही रुक जा, कल ही चला जाना, जब फिर महाप्रभु विशाल समुद्र जाने के लिए तैयारी होते फिर रोने लग जाते, कहते प्रभु आप अभी अभी आए इतना जल्दी क्यों और उस दिन रुक जाओ, लेकिन महाप्रभु को तो बहुत सारी काम करना है। महाप्रभु ने कहा एक दिन देखो गोविंदा, अगर मैं यहाँ पर रुकूंगा तो मेरे लीला कैसे निर्भर होगी, इसलिए मेरा संभव नहीं।
This place reminds us both the pastimes of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Krishna. Here we see Samadhi of Gauridas Pandit, and at the same time this place is called Dheer Samir. Dheer Samir reminds us the Ras of Krishna, and Gauridas Pandit reminds us Mahaprabhu's pastime. Krishna is playing our flute. Here is Dheer Samir. What is the Dheer Samir? Samir, cool breeze, became heavy and started blowing very slow. So they made me heavy so that I should also become very slow. So Dheer, Krishna is playing our flute, all gopis have come here. Krishna is performing Ras dance. In Ras dance, everything begins stern. Moon stop to see Ras dance. Similarly, this blowing wind, breeze, it also stopped and started blowing very, very slowly. So it is called a Tirthamit. Another pastime which took place of Goridas Pandit, that is really interesting to hear. Goridas Pandit was very strong devotee of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. In Krishna's pastime, he is none other than Subhalsakha. They are friendly to each other. Once Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu came to the house of Goridas Pandit, and Goridas Pandit served him so much, served them so much that they were very much pleased. Now after some time they said, we have to leave your house. No, 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 I won't let you go. You are so dear to me. I cannot be without you. Oh Goridas, finally we have to go. You do one thing. We will leave you. We will leave two statues of ours and you just serve them. It will be equivalent as if you are serving us. So let us go. Okay, okay, give your statue. So, Goridas Pandit gave two vigrahs of Nityananda Prabhu and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They gave Goridas Pandit two vigrahs of Nityananda and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Now when both started going, then again Goridas Pandit said, please, Lord, I can't leave you. Well, vigrahs are there, they are standing in my house. What can I do? You are my talking Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu. I cannot leave you. Okay, then we will stay here. Nityananda Prabhu and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they stayed at one corner of Goridas Pandit. And those vigrahs, they started now going out. When they were going out, Goridas Pandit ran after them and stopped them. Why are you going out? He says, well, when you have taken Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu themselves, then what is use of ours here? Let us go. No, 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 you stay here. So sometimes Mahaprabhu and Nityananda is going, then Goridas Pandit is stopping them, and sometimes their vigra is going, Goridas Pandit is stopping them. And this pastime took place for a very long time, and finally Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, that proves our vigra is not other than us. So please keep them and don't consider that we have gone, we are with you. So then finally he took those vigrahs, he served those vigrahs, very friendly he was serving. He had one disciple, his name was Vidyanand. And this Vidyanand was very, very dedicated devotee of his guru. Once it was on the eve of Mahaprabhu's appearance day, Vidyanand wanted to give a very big feast, but his Gurudev was not present. In feast, two things are important, arranging the feast and inviting the high advanced devotees. And the invitation must be on the behalf of Gurudev. So when Gurudev was not present, Hidyananda invited all the devotees and the Vaishnavas of the locality on behalf of his Gurudev. And he arranged for the feast. When his Gurudev came and he came to know that Hidyananda has invited all the devotees on his behalf without taking permission, then he took a sulky mood. He came in man. Oh, you are not my disciple. You are doing of your own. Go away. Run away from here. But disciple is also very strong disciple. He has nothing doing. He went at the bank of Ganges and he started doing very jubilant kirtan, and he was in the mood of having feast there for all the Vaishnavas. So when he was arranging the feast and doing jubilant kirtan, then Nityananda Prabhu and Mahaprabhu of Goridas Pandit, they came to him and they also started participating in that jubilant kirtan. And when Goridas Pandit went to offer them prasad, he finds that in his altar there was no Nityananda Prabhu and Mahaprabhu. Where have they gone? Have they gone, or Hidyananda has taken them? So he took a stick, that if Hidyananda has taken them, then I will beat Mahaprabhu, I will beat Nityananda Prabhu, and I will beat my disciple. So he went with a stick in a very angry mood, and when he went there, reached there, he found that Nityananda Prabhu and Mahaprabhu are dancing with his disciple Hidyananda, and they were so much absorbed, and he came with a stick, oh, you are dancing here, you have left my house, and he was angry. Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu were so much skilled of Goridas Pandit that they very quickly ran into the hall of Vidyadhan. And when they went into the hall of Vidyadhan, at that time Goridas Pandit, when he saw, then he threw his stick and then he embraced his disciples. You are such a high class of devotee that Mahaprabhu is taking shelter in your heart. From now your name is no more Hityanand, you have become Hitya Ketanand. So this part is
ब्रजगोपियों को आकर्षण किया, जबकि उन्होंने देखा पूर्णिमा की चांदनी रात पूर्व दिशा में चंद्रमा उदित हुए हैं। गोल पिंड गोलाकार पिंड रूपे नवीन कुमकुम पिंड रूपे चंद्रमा पूर्व दिशा से उदित हुए थे। से देखे एहन का स्मरण कर समस्त प्रजगोपियों को राधा जी के महाभाव रस को आस्वादन कराने के लिए तथा उनकी प्रेममय सेवा को ग्रहण करने के लिए कृष्ण ने उनके हृदय भूत रस को आस्वादन करने के लिए यहाँ पर सबको बुलाया। जगौ कलम बाम त्रिशाम मनोहरम। इतने दिनों तक उन्होंने कृष्ण मंत्र का गायन किया, गोपियां आकर्षित हुई हैं और गोपियों का चित्त मन चुराया है, परंतु गोपियां दौड़ करके कभी आई नहीं। परंतु आज तो जैसे ही बंसी बजाई, बंसी के स्वर सुनते ही साथ ही साथ कृष्ण दौड़ करके ये समस्त ब्रज गोपियां वहां पर दौड़ करके आ गई, जो जहाँ जिस स्थिति में थी उसी स्थिति में वहां पर उपस्थित हो गई। इसलिए मंत्र के साथ में बीज होता है, बिना बीज के मंत्र उच्चारण करने से फल नहीं होता है। मंत्र मंत्र देवता का ध्यान, मंत्र मूर्ति का स्मरण, उनका पूजन और उनका चिंतन होता है। तो मंत्र के साथ में मंत्र देवता का आवाहन, तो मंत्र देवता साथ ही साथ उपस्थित हो गए, जो कि मंत्र के अधिष्ठात्री देवता है विश्वभानु नंदिनी श्री राधा जी। इसलिए उनके साथ में समस्त ब्रज गोपियां जो कि गोपीजन है, समस्त गोपियां वहां पर समुपस्थित हो गए श्री कृष्ण के आवाहन मात्र से। और उनके साथ में उन्होंने रास विहार किया। तो रास विहार ऐसे नहीं होता है, पहले अनुराग दर्शाया जाता है, उसमें भी बम और दक्षिण युक्त भाव। जब गोपियां दक्षिण भाव से आ गई तो कृष्ण टेढ़े हो करके उनके साथ व्यंग वचन कहना शुरू कर दिया। व्यंग वाते
स्वरूपम रूपं तस्याग्रजम् रिपुरीं मातुरीं मुक्त्वाचं राधा कुन्दवतीरिवं अहोराधिका माधवासं रक्तो यस्या प्रतिरक्षणा श्रीगुरुं तं नतोऽस्मि। By the causes mercy of Sri Guru and Vaishnavas, in the course of performing our parikrama, now we have come to this place. It is called Bhangsivash. This is the place where Krishna played upon his flute and invited all the Raja Gopis to take part in Rasa Lila. So, Pujapad Bhaktivedanta Tirtha Maharaj has spoken some nice katha. I will translate this Hari Katha. Flowers of all seasons began to bloom by the arrangement of Jogmaya and inspired the desire in the heart of Krishna that he should taste the very astonishing prema rasa. The horizon is not the wife of the moon, yet the moon was decorating the eastern horizon with a reddish color, just as a lover decorates his beloved with kumkum. So upon seeing this, the inspiration to taste the parakya rasa of the gopis of Vrindavan came in the heart of Krishna. But he was thinking, oh, how can I do this? This will break all the rules of a dharma. But then Jogamaya in his heart told him, no, this tradition is coming in your dynasty because you have appeared in the dynasty of the moon. So this is coming in your dynasty. No harm, you can go. That time Krishna, he came here to Bhangsivash and began to play on his flute. So Shukadeva Goswami saying, Jagau Kalam Bama Drisham Manoharam. This means, Jagau Kalam. He's playing very sweet and soft notes upon his flute. Bama Drisham, the gopis who have very attractive sidelong glances. Manoharam, he's attracting their minds. But in this line of Srimad Bhagavatam, Shukadeva Goswami is giving us one shiksha, one instruction. What is that? Oh. Vrindavane aprakrita navina madan kama gayatri kama bij yara upasan. One should take shelter of Kam Gayatri, this mantra, this is the sound of Krishna's flute. Jago Ka Lam Pamadrasham Manoharam. Here, the sweet singing of Krishna's flute is Kala. So this is Ka La. Pamadrasham means, oh, the gopis whose eyes have very attractive glances. But another meaning of Pamadrasham means the fourth letter of the alphabet, A, A, E, E, this long I. And Manoharam means enchanting the mind. The presiding deity of the mind is Chandrama. So in Sanskrit, this Chandra Bindu is there. So Ka, La, E and Chandra Bindu, this is Kaam Beach. So this instruction has been given by Shukadeva Goswami in Srimad Bhagavatam. So by this mantra, Krishna playing on his flute, he called all the gopis. So Prabhupada is describing how all the gopis, they came here and met with Krishna. But when Krishna met with them, he spoke very crooked words, very crooked language. Swagatam va mahabhaga priyam kim karavani va. Oh, welcome. Why have you come here? Is there any problem in your homes? I think that you should not be here in this very dangerous forest in the middle of the night. Because any lady should serve her husband. This is her dharma and her duty. If the husband is old, if he is sick, lame, blind, bad character, anyway, if the wife serves her husband, then she can attain a good destination. Otherwise, she will not be able to go to heaven and she cannot have a good reputation and have any happiness. So in this way, Krishna spoke very crookedly to the gopis. But the gopis, they replied to him with even more crooked words. Kastrangate kalapadaya tavena gita sambhavitara nacha charitam nacha letrilokyam. Oh Krishna, we know that what is the proper behavior? Pratamam tu gurum pujam tatastaya mamarchanam. We should serve our Gurudev before anyone else. This is the first thing. So you are giving us such good advice, such good instructions. This means that you must be our guru. So first we'll serve you, and then afterwards we can return to our husbands. So in this way, very sweet conversations, full of rasa, took place between Krishna and the gopis, here in this place at Bangsibat. Then Ras Lila began, and Shrimati Radharani, seeing that Krishna was treating all gopis equally with her, she had man, and she left this place, and went to Sringarvat, this katar we've heard yesterday. So, I have described in essence the Katara of Tirtha Maharaj. We have not so much time today. So, Bhangsivat ki jai, Rajendranandan Shama Sunda Gopinath Ju ki jai.
Krishna ki, prem ki, aur koi sringar ki baat batate hai, wo jarur us slok ke andar mein, aise kuch vastu ka heat ingit dete hai, jisko tarah sadhakon ko savdhan kar dete hai. इसलिए जब वे रास प्रसंग में ये प्रसंग आने पर पहले श्लोक में अभी महाराज बता रहे थे भगवान अपि तारात्रि शरद उत्फुल्ल मल्लिका विक्षरंतु मनस चक्र जोग माया मुपाश्रित. इसलिए पहले ही उन्होंने बोल दिया देखो भगवान रास रचा रहे हैं इसलिए आप लोग भी मत सोचो तो मैं कटाक्ष करते हैं. इसलिए श्रील सुख हमारे श्रीधर स्वामी बता रहे हैं कहते ये जो रास लीला है ना ये कृष्ण का काम विजय लीला है. उन्होंने काम के प्रति उन्होंने विजय प्राप्त किया. जो सिद्धांत तत्व दर्शन को ऊपर में जाने चाहते हैं उनके लिए बता रहे हैं कि उनको काम विजय लीला है. जिस समय काम देव ने बड़े अहंकार करके शंकर जी को भी परास्त किया, ब्रह्मा जी को भी परास्त किया, सारे ऋषियों को परास्त किया, कृष्ण को पास में भी हुए, अपना पांच बाण लेकर के आए, कृष्ण को साथ में भी उन्हें लड़ाई किया, लेकिन उनको कोई बाण कृष्ण के ऊपर काम नहीं किया. लेकिन कृष्ण जब अपना तिरछ चितवन उन्होंने कामदेव के ऊपर में छोड़ते हैं, कामदेव वहां पर पानी पानी हो जाते हैं और यहीं पर उनके चरण में लोट मोट खाने लग जाते हैं. कहते प्रभु कृपा करके आप मेरे को भी एक चरण की दासी बना लो. इसलिए वो सिद्धांत पक्ष में यहाँ पर दिखा रहे हैं भगवान काम में मुग्ध नहीं हुए, काम के ऊपर विजय प्राप्त किया. रसिकों के लिए नहीं, यहाँ पर कृष्ण गोपियों के प्रेम में बसीभूत हो गए. इसलिए इस स्थान कोई साधारण वस्तु नहीं, लेकिन आम व्यक्ति ये यहाँ आकर के भगवत दिव्य लीला सुनकर कभी
हम तारा खोज करते लाइल खोज करते करते देखेगी जे ऐसे कोना से एक मेय बसे आते তো দেখতে তো মেয়ে অবিকল মেয়ে কোনো ভেদ নাই, কিন্তু অজানা অচেনা মতো মনে হচ্ছে যেন কোনোদিন তাকে দেখেন নাই। সেই জন্য গোপীরা এখন ধরে ফেলেছে, বলে তোর নাম কি? নাম তো এখন জানা নাই, শিব ঠাকুরের নিজের নাম বলতে পারছে না যে আমি ভোলানাথ শিব। এখন নাম তো জানা নাই, পৌর্ণমাসী তো বলে নাই, তো বলে তোমার বাড়ি কোথায় সেটুকুও জানা নাই, এখন কৈলাসও বলতে পারছে না।
So one who is the supreme personality of Lord and is capable to perform this pastime, we are not capable to perform the pastime. So we should be cautious in this regard. And secondly, I'm telling the things in very brief. We have been to Gopeshwar Mahadev also, when we had no Harikatha over there about Gopeshwar Mahadev. When this ras was being performed by Krishna here, so Shiv Thakur had a curiosity to see that this ras. So he wanted to come in, but he cannot enter into it. He approached Puranamashi. Puranamashi then gave him benediction. He had a dip here in nearby Sarovar, and he became a very beautiful girl. So he went inside the ras, but now there was no enjoyment in ras. So gopis are saying that probably some vijatiya, outcasted person has come inside our ras, we have to find out. Then this girl who was first time being seen by them, they spotted her and they started asking, who are you? So Shiv Thakur has become gopi, but he did not know about her identity like it. What is your name? She could not tell that I am Shiva. So he was to be remained mum. Who is your husband? Where is your village? All these questions she could not reply. Then gopi just started giving punches to her. And then he cried, Puranamashi, please come and save me. Puranamashi came, oh stop, he is Lord Shiva, he wanted to see Ras. Then Krishna came and Krishna said, oh Shiva, you cannot perform pastimes of Ras with us, but you can do one thing. From the distance you can see and you perform one duty also on the Ishan cone. There are 8 directions. At the one direction which is called Ishan, you stay there and your duty is that you will not let any outcasted person here inside our Ras and see it from the distance. So Gopeshwar, Gurudev says, Gopeshwar means He is the person whose gopis are their Ishwar. So Lord Shiva has accepted gopi as his Ishwar. So his name is Gopeshwar. Gaur Premanande.
Beautiful.
Thank you. बोले कि वो राधे, बिंदा जी बोले वो राधे, तुम्हारे लिए